The military has moved into New York to build the USA's first field hospital to cope with a surge of victims. But as the death toll soars, so does the economic crisis. The US president suggesting he might reconsider social isolation orders, saying we cannot let the cure be worse than the problem itself.
While the world waits and economies collapse, Washington does nothing.
The country is burning.
Republicans and Democrats bickering over details of the biggest rescue package in history and the most urgent.
They ought to be embarrassed, Mr. President. The American people have had enough of this nonsense.
For the second time in as many days, Democrats blocked the bill, arguing it's merely a bailout for big corporations that leaves workers behind. And yet the president, ever optimistic.
This was a medical problem. We are not going to let it turn into a long-lasting financial problem. America will again and soon be open for business, a lot sooner than 3 or 4 months.
It's unfathomable at a time when the military is moving into multiple states declared major disaster zones, including New York, ground zero for the disease in this country. The National Guard took control of the biggest convention centre in the city to install 2,000 beds.
This will be a backfill.
What's so surreal about this situation is how quickly things are changing. In November, runners were here picking up their New York marathon tops. Just last month, this centre hosted the Western Hemisphere's biggest toy fair, and now the military is in here, handling a global pandemic. The state's governor toured the facility.
Australia is only just facing the lockdowns, cafes closing, restaurants closing, so we're a bit behind the US and New York State specifically. With what you're now seeing, what would your advice be to Australians about how serious this is and what they should be doing?
It is as serious as a matter of life and death. My advice would be act sooner and act more dramatically. There'll be some people who say this is media hype. They are wrong. They are wrong.
In New York, Alexis Daish, 9 News.
Our US correspondent Charles Croucher has the breakdown on what this all means from Washington, D.C. Charles, this is a battle between health and the economy.
It is, Pete, and you would suggest the economy is winning. That stimulus package simply has to pass, but each hour of delay spreads uncertainty that makes it all the way to New South Wales. Here at the White House, the president is already talking about reopening America for business. His tweets suggest isolating the vulnerable and sending everyone back to work, but this virus has taught us across more than 150 countries that it will spread, and the more it spreads, the more flags that will fly at half-mast. Tonight, we're learning this will happen in weeks and not months. That's far sooner than first expected, far sooner than Australia, and far sooner than even the president's own medical experts recommend.